Do you know that in Japan, approximately 85% of PET bottles produced are recycled? By recycled, I mean they are regenerated into new plastic products. Compared to the United States, only less than 30% of PET bottles are recycled. The rest, they are either burnt, left in a landfill, or up till last year, sent to China. And we all know that this has been a major problem, and even bigger now, just recently. So, why this difference? Or rather, what determines the recyclable value of PET bottles? We all know that they have to be cleaned to be recycled. But actually, colored PET bottles are the ones that 100% goes into incineration. We can't see any colored PET bottles here in Japan, but if you go to other countries, like me, I'm from Malaysia, it is normal to drink from a colored PET bottle. So, what should we do with all of these colored PET bottles? Here's where my research topic is. I transform them into coal through a method called carbonization. It's very easy. Just remove oxygen from air and heat them up. Trapping carbon from plastic waste in the form of coal can not only help reduce greenhouse gas emission, but also solve limited landfill problems. Not only that, I also plan to upgrade all of this coal into active carbon, an excellent carbon dioxide adsorbent. So up to last month, I had successfully trapped up to 40% of carbon in the form of coal and only emitted less than 10% of carbon dioxide. If we substitute 100 million tons of carbon dioxide that is to be emitted from only burning PET bottles yearly into carbonization, we save up to 90 million tons of carbon dioxide. Wait, this is where it gets exciting. If we transform all of this coal into active carbon, we can trap more carbon dioxide that is already existing in our atmosphere. That is, we create a minus carbon dioxide emission. Pretty cool, isn't it? We stop global warming with plastics. Thank you very much.